Formnext is right around the corner, and you know what that means. Exciting new products from all of your favorite 3D printing brands. So here are the 35 most exciting new, unreleased, and rumored products coming out this quarter in consumer 3D printing, including many I got exclusive first looks at during my recent trip to China. And trust me, I'm saving some very juicy scuttlebutt for the end of this video. Let's get after it. All right, diving in, we've got a lot of ground to cover, so we're going to go very, very fast through these, and I will leave links in the descriptions below if you'd like to learn more and support the channel should you choose to purchase any of this stuff. Before we get into new printers and new filaments though, let's start off with a company that has been extremely prolific in the past few years, churning out exciting new upgrade products, which is BigTreeTech. First off, we have the Panda Station, a multifunctional storage solution for your P, X, A, or even H series bamboo printers, with adaptations coming for Creality machines and more. This awesome rolling cabinet is available with and without panels, allowing you to not only replace your rickety old lac stack, but also store filament, tools, and more. I'm really excited to get my hands on this one because I suspect that they're going to come out with a chamber dehumidifier too, turning this into a multifunctional dry storage solution for hygroscopic filaments. Prices start at just $299 before upgrades. Upgrades, you might ask? Well, yes, there are lots of upgrades. Perhaps most notably the Panda Den, an add-on unit that adds more storage and waste management to either your standard table or your Panda Station. Check out the ingenious way that it makes clearing poops an absolute breeze. The base price is $159, but packages are available with the Panda Station. So those are just the big new announcements from BIQU or BigTreeTech, but when I was visiting them in Shenzhen, I also discovered half a dozen or more similar upgrades, including the Panda Diaper, Panda Aura, and Panda Jetpack V2. So I will leave links to all of that in the description below. For now, let's move on to another one of my favorite brands and another channel sponsor, Polymaker, who has been hard at work releasing some very exciting new filaments. First off, we have their new PPS GF20, a glass fiber reinforced version of their legendary PPS filament, but with low conductivity and flame retardant properties. You're looking at around $59.99 for a 500 gram roll. In addition to the PPS GF, Polymaker recently unveiled a PET GF at TCT Shenzhen, which is perfect for larger electronics projects that require that rigidity without conducting electricity. They were showing off a pretty insane large format drone made of this stuff, and at just $24.29 for a 500 gram spool, I can easily see people using this filament for larger scale robotics projects. Additionally, Polymaker has now introduced a glass fiber reinforced version of their impressive ht-pla, ht-pla GF, which offers better rigidity and dimensional accuracy. These ones are also available in your favorite tool brand's colors, making them ideal for tool accessories and upgrades. You can get a 1 kilo spool for $29.99. Finally, Polymaker now offers a range of ASA CF filaments, including some lighter colors that we typically don't see with carbon fiber filaments, such as teal and tan. If you need to print something both rigid and UV stable, you can pick up a 500 gram spool of this stuff for just $19.99. Up next, let's have a look at Siraya Tech, who is making a big push into unique and engineering grade filaments lately. First, we've got their new PIBA Air. It offers high rebound active foaming, allowing you to adjust the hardness from 70 to 95A by temperature and reduce the weight by up to 50%. It's also biocompatible certified, making it perfect for wearable devices. Now this one is actually already sold out, but it will be $69.99 for an 800 gram spool when back in stock. Up next, we have Siraya Tech's ABS HT-HF. As the name suggests, this one offers high speed with 101C heat resistance, and it's priced at just $19.49 a spool. Finally, Siraya Tech is pleased to introduce their own PPA GF, an ultra-high strength, high-performance nylon composite with superior rigidity and chemical resistance. The price on this one is still TBD, but we'll put a link in the description once it becomes available. While we're looking at new filaments, the folks over at QIDI did want me to let you guys know that they now offer RFID-enabled spools of their PETG and PLA Basic with competitive prices from just $16.99 a spool. To my knowledge, those RFID tags will only work with the QIDI box, but during my recent trip to China, I spent about half my time campaigning for companies like Polymaker, SUNLU, Elegoo, Creality, and Snapmaker to adopt a single open RFID standard that works across all filaments and all printers. So far, a lot of these companies have expressed an interest and willingness, and I think we all just need to vote with our wallets. So drop a comment below if that's something you would like to see happen as well. Up next, let's have a look at Phaetus, who unveiled a bunch of exciting new products at TCT Shenzhen. First, we have the Phaetus ArcFly line of Conweb cool plates, which offer superior adhesion at lower temperatures. These are currently available for this select range of printers, with more hopefully coming soon. And the price is as low as $28.99. Phaetus also announced a new conch, high flow, and hardened nozzle for the H2D, A1, and A1 Mini. At just $29.99, though, you can probably understand why this one is already sold out. Additionally, Phaetus unveiled some high flow and coat super hardened nozzles for the K2 series, which are available in both 0.4 and 0.6 variants at the same low price. And finally, Phaetus was showing off some really impressive TPU air foaming filaments, which use that same technology we talked about earlier to reduce weight. What I found really unique about these though is that the end texture is much more like EVA foam once printed. Now, because of the foaming thing, a 1 kilo spool will take you pretty far, but it does cost $49. Up next, let's switch gears and talk about SUNLU, another company I recently got the chance to tour, though I do think that that video is going to be coming out on our second channel, so we'll link in the description so you can get subscribed over there as well. Anyways, they're going to be announcing the FiliDryer S4 Pro, a follow-up to their popular S4 dryer. It features dual nozzle control, 85 degree max drying temperature, optimized airflow and heating, and a more user-friendly design. No word on pricing yet, though. While we're talking about filament dryers, let's talk about Eibos, who I recently had the chance to visit in Foshan. Now, I don't have any official release dates or anything like that, but I was able to confirm that they are working on adapting their Tetras AMS dryer system to more ecosystems, including the Creality CFS. So, as you no doubt noticed, I am currently away from my studio and visiting family in California, and that's just been absolutely great. But the only part that really gets on my nerves is that all of my projects are not moving forward while I'm here. Or, well, they wouldn't be if it weren't for today's sponsor, PCBWay. You see, no matter where I am in the world, even if I don't have access to my laser cutters, 3D printers, CNC machines, and more, I can rely on PCBWay to deliver those parts to me at a great price, no matter where I am. Whether I need parts 3D printed in heavy industrial materials like tool steel or PEEK, or I need injection molded parts, sheet metal fabrication, or CNC machine titanium, PCBWay can do it all. They can ship it anywhere in the world that FedEx, DHL, and UPS arrive, and their prices are fantastic. So even if you happen to be traveling this coming holiday season, don't worry, you can still make forward progress on your projects or check out some of their amazing shared projects in the project library. Check out the link in the description to save $5 off your first order, and thanks to PCBWay for supporting this channel. All right, let's get back to the rumor mill, shall we? All right, we're about to get into new 3D printer speculation and rumors, but before we do, I have a couple more 3D printer upgrade manufacturers, starting with Wham Bam. First off, they've got three new slap products to improve post-processing and painting. These are the $23 slap palette, paint palette setup, the $15 slap caddy, which contains all of your resin tools and drips, and the $10 slap well, a handy brush cleaner, resin mix container, and even small part cleaning vessel. Check the link in the description for ordering information. Then they've announced the ultimate drip wall and drip table, which is a convenient vat hanger that you either sit on a table or mount to a wall, which allows you to perform no hands wipe down and drip dry any resin printer vat into your bottle. I definitely need this, and it's a bargain for just $39. Finally, Wham Bam is now offering their popular ultimate accessories as a trio, including their silicone funnel, spatula, and vat cleaning tool. I've been using these a lot recently with a new resin printer that I'm testing, and I gotta say that they are awesome, and they're now available as a package for just $32. All right. Transitioning into full 3D printers, let's start out with the DIY kits from LDO Motors, who apparently has been very busy developing new products for 2026. First, we have the Rolohan Delta Flyer, LDO's first ever Delta 3D printer kit. It's designed by Rolohan, it features a lower cost of just $389.99, and it's an easier build than most other kit 3D printers. So, link in the description to pre-order at some of LDO's retailers. Up next, we have the LDO Micron Plus kit. Now, if you haven't heard of the Micron, well, you probably should watch my whole video about the lesser known open source 3D printer projects that you can build. But until you get around to doing that, it's basically a compact, high-speed Voron 2.4 derivative, and because this kit is made by LDO, you just know that it's got all the highest quality electronics and hardware and motors as well. Pre-orders start at $819.99, and assembly is, of course, on you. And finally, LDO is pleased to announce their new Boron CNC AWD kit. This kit offers a bunch of benefits, starting with the better heat dissipation of stepper motors running at higher currents. You've got shorter effective belt lengths between tool head and drive gear, and improved max acceleration, input shaper results, and better accuracy during direction changes. It's all pretty fancy. Prices start at $199.99, and additional motors are sold separately. So we've arrived at the 3D printer portion of the video, and we're going to start from the confirmed and unveiled and work our way to the rumored in hushed tones. At the top of our list, we have FLSun, who unveiled two new Delta 3D printers at TCT Asia. The first was the confusingly named T1 Max, which is the lower priced unenclosed upgrade to last year's T1 Pro. I guess the Max name is because it does have a larger build volume of 300 by 297. Now this printer is pretty clearly targeted towards print farms. It touts always on reliability, easy maintenance, and other production ready features. And I think for $499, they're probably gonna sell quite a few of them for that purpose. But the big, pun intended, news from FLSun has gotta be the V400 Max, a massive 500 by 550 millimeter beast that can reach 350 degrees Celsius. It's currently available for $1,199, but FLSun does plan to increase the price very soon. And now let's get into some unreleased printers, starting with AtomForm, a startup that recently teased their Palette 300 printer. Now this system claims to have 12 auto swapping nozzles, as well as a filament management system to feed them. Now details on this printer are extremely scant. They wouldn't even let me visit without my camera while I was in Shenzhen, but I can say that according to my Chinese sources, this company was internally incubated by home electronics powerhouse Dreamy, with some of their top R&D brass coming from Dreamy as well. So it is definitely worth paying attention to. Up next, let's get even more speculative and talk about the upcoming Core 1 multi-material system teased by Joseph Prusa a month or so ago. From what we've seen, most of the internet sleuths agree that this is going to be a collaboration between Prusa and Bontech, featuring 7 material capability at a fraction of the cost of tool changer or even nozzle swapping systems. For my money though, I would bet that Prusa is planning to debut this system either at or before Formnext in hopes of stealing the thunder of some of their other competitors like Bambu Lab, who are expected to debut the Vortech nozzle swapping system at the show. Yes, you heard that right. I did mention Bambu Lab in a video because even though we no longer work together, sad face, no discussion of the rumor mill in China would be complete without talking about them. I think we can all agree that their Vortech announcement a month and a half ago felt like a pretty rushed knee-jerk reaction to the success of the Snapmaker U1. But I think that in order to save face, they're going to have to show up with a working prototype at Formnext. Personally, I'm very curious to see if and how they've handled the filament swaps properly, because although it can clearly swap nozzles very quickly, when you only have one or two extruders, you are still going to need to retract, cut, feed, and change the filament for every material change. As for what else they have cooking, there are a lot of rumors on the street, but very little actual substance. I've heard that they're working on a resin printer, a replacement for the smaller X1 and P1 form factor, and even that they recently acquired one of the mid-size filament manufacturers to move their filament production in-house. Unfortunately, they remain pretty good at containing leaks, at least until they're ready for a so-called leak to drum up excitement. Suspicious. We're now moving from the confirmed but unreleased to the sketchier in development, prototypes exist, but I can't really talk about it portion of the video. A lot of this stuff is kept under tight wraps, but I did check and I am able to say this. During my time in China, I got a chance to check out a prototype of Anycubic's next multicolor printer, a printer that uses some unique tricks to minimize purge while maintaining a very, very low cost. Now this printer will compete favorably with the Bambu Lab A1s and Creality Highs of the world. So if you're in the market for one of those printers, maybe wait till you see what Anycubic has in store. And now we've arrived at the purely speculative, the little cherry on top for those of you who stuck around till the end. And hopefully I won't get in trouble for this. As usual, when I'm in China, I did a lot of poking around and asking very cheeky questions. And of course, I can't reveal any of my sources, but the Shenzhen rumor mill has confirmed that Creality is working on a tool changer for 2026. No, I haven't seen any prototypes, nor do I have any more information besides that, but I can pretty confidently say that we will see a tool changer from Creality in 2026. And given Creality's history of bringing down prices on newer technologies and producing printers at scale, this alone, alongside the massive success of the Snapmaker U1, could mean that we're gonna see a meaningful democratization of true multi-material printing in 2026. Fingers crossed. But there you have it, 35 of the most exciting new 3D printing products coming to market for 2026, from the available now to the wildly speculative. But I'd love to know in the comments below, which ones are you guys the most excited about? And did I miss anything? I do read all my comments, but I can't go on Twitter anymore. It's just too much of a mess. So you guys gotta keep me filled in. Anyways, that's all for this week, but I'll see all of you on the next layer.